Hello, and welcome to this evening's Live with Bucky live session. Thank you so much for making time to be with us tonight. Tonight, we actually have a very special session that is all about graduate housing. So this session is specifically for graduate students and students with families. So what we're going to be doing is really exploring the three neighborhoods that we have in university apartments. So we're going to talk about Eagle Heights, Harvey Street, and University Houses. So another great thing is we're actually going to be answering your questions live. So I see you guys have already been putting those questions into the live section of this video. So please continue to do that. Go ahead and put those in the comments and we're going to get to them very shortly. I also wanted to mention that if you would like to watch a replay of this live stream after it's over, or actually view any of our other Live with Bucky live streams, you can be sure to check out our Live with Bucky Live page, and you can find that at go.wisc.edu/livewithbuckylive. So right there along the bottom of the screen. So before we actually dive into questions here and talk a little bit about our graduate housing options, I would like to introduce who we have here with us today. So I'm going to actually start with myself. So hello, everyone. My name is Sarah, and I actually work on the marketing and communications team here at University Housing. So with that, I'm going to bring in Andrew to tell us a little bit about himself.
Hi there. Thank you, Sarah. My name is Andrew Werner, and I am one of the assistant directors of resident support services here at University Apartments. Mainly, I supervise our office staff as well as our programming staff, and we can't wait to get back to doing programs. Hossein.
Hi, I'm Hossein. I'm happy to be with you today, and I am a resident manager. So we facilitate issues with residents, and it's technical, social. We provide and cater events and try to make your time and stay here at U Houses a great time. And I am the RM of the 300s and 400s, so a part of the Eagle Heights community. Thank you. And we have Ashley here too with us.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Ashley. I am the resident manager for what I think is the coolest neighborhood, Harvey Street. So I'm so excited to be here with you all tonight or whenever you're watching this so you can learn more about Harvey Street, University Apartments, and Eagle Heights.
Thanks a lot, you guys. As you can see, we've got a great panel of people here. So one thing I did want to mention that's really great about having Ashley and Hossein here is they actually are live-in staff. So they are actually graduate students or pursuing higher degrees themselves. So they are in your community. They're there for you when you need them. So that's really a great people to have here on our panel today. So just a reminder, if you're joining us a little later after we've started, tonight we are exploring graduate housing options in university housing, specifically university apartments. So if you have a question, please drop it into the comment section of this video and we're gonna get to them actually very shortly. If by chance, your question, we don't get a chance to get to it today, or honestly, you're watching this and later tonight, you're like, oh, I really wish I had the opportunity to ask them something. Don't worry about it. You've got a great way to get in contact with us, and that is by filling out our contact us form. And that can be found at go.wisc.edu/housing-contact. So when you fill that out, you'll just check the graduate housing or university apartment section. And that's going to go to some of these great staff here that we have today to be able to answer those questions. So I see we've got some questions rolling in here. And I actually think I'm going to kick it off tonight with one of our questions that we have. So I'm actually going to bring Andrew in here. So this first question is going to go to you, Andrew. So we have a question here, and it's kind of about arrivals. So this is, if our flights arrive at night, can we check in the university apartment late at night? So that would be after 11 p.m. So how do you guys handle that?
Yeah, that's a very good question. We are actually forming something new in order for our resident managers who work very hard. We are asking that all check-ins go from about 8 a.m. to 9 p.m. And also out of consideration of our residents that live here as well. So once your lease is accepted, And once you have reserved your slot to live here, our office staff will reach out to you and we will get all that information taken care of. And then you will get the contact number of our resident manager who will be able to assist you between those hours of 8 a.m. and 9 p.m.
Perfect. Thanks a lot, Andrew. I guess since you're here, I'm really kind of curious if you can kind of give us a general overview of University Apartments. So what's there in that community and kind of maybe tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, absolutely. You mean what's here in this beautiful community? University Apartments, or UA as it is known, it is home to about 2,500 residents, about 1,200 apartments, over 83 acres. So it's a very large community. We also have about 80 different countries that are represented in this community. It's a really wonderful place. And we are available to graduate students, students with families, postdoc research, academic staff, university staff, faculty and their families, as well as undergraduates with dependents. And we have three neighborhoods, as was mentioned earlier: Eagle Heights, which is located on the northwest edge of this campus, surrounded by woods, and it's right on the shore of Lake Mendota, as you can kind of see on that Google map. Lots of playgrounds and picnic areas, and we're close to the community center, where when we are fully open is where our we have a gymnasium here and where our events are mostly held in the community center. The apartments of Eagle Heights are apartment style units, 1, 2, and 3 bedrooms. They are mostly unfurnished. We do have some furnished units in what's called our 100s area, and they're 1 and 2 bedroom units as well. So that looks like it is a unfurnished unit in Eagle Heights. But this is one of our larger apartments that you'll see. And most of our apartments do not have laundry in unit. That was a very lucky one that we have. But laundry is here and free, included with your rent in the basement of your buildings. University Houses is our second neighborhood. University Houses is located, nestled between the woods of the Lakeshore Preserve, Eagle Heights, and it's also close to the village of Shorewood Hills, close to the bus line, right on a bike path, and again, wonderful picnic and playground areas, and it's also close to another community gardens. We have two on our property. And these are townhouse style units. And again, it is 1, 2, and 3 bedroom units. All of these units are unfurnished. And as you can see, all of this information is on our website as well. Pictures, a nice virtual tour, so you can kind of see what we are talking about tonight. And lastly, Harvey Street. So Harvey Street is located a half mile west of campus, just south of University Apartments, conveniently located on Harvey Street. It's close to shops, restaurants. It's actually right by a good bagel place called Bagels Forever. It's right in your parking lot. Community offers space for small gatherings and grills, easy access to the bus line. Those are 1 and 2 bedroom units, apartment style units as well. All of these units are furnished, as you can see. And all of these units will serve single grad students. So a thing that your rent will include is a free parking space in Eagle Heights and University Houses. Additional parking spots or parking at Harvey Street are $40 a month. You get high-speed campus internet, free access to the bus service, which is called the 80, cable TV, heat, water, trash, recycling, and probably one of the best things we have here is 24-hour on-call maintenance and on-call customer service with our maintenance staff and with our resident managers. Leases themselves are for a year. Okay, so University Houses and Eagle Heights have leases that go from July 1st to June 30th, and Harvey Street has leases that go from June 1st to May 31st. You can start your lease at any time. So let's say you start your lease January 15th. Your first lease would go until June 30th, and then you'll renew for a full year. So the lease applications are accepted year-round. And if you get a wonderful opportunity after you graduate here to go work or live in your dream location, it's just a 90-day notice that we need of rent obligation to get out of that. So you don't have to worry about staying for the entire year with that.
Perfect. Thanks, Andrew. I know kind of talking about the options that we have is really helpful for people to understand. We actually have a couple questions that have come in here that I'd really like to see if you could field for us while you're here. So the one question that we did get was, and this is from CH, do you find it easier for applicants to find vacancies in 1, 2, or 3 bedroom apartments in Eagle Heights?
Yeah, thank you, CH. It's going to be 2 bedrooms because we have way more 2 bedrooms than the others. We have about 700 2-bedroom apartments and about 280 1-bedroom apartments in Eagle Heights. And 3 bedrooms, there's only about 25, I believe. So 2 bedrooms is where you're going to find the most vacancy with that.
Perfect. Thanks a lot, Andrew. So I think I would like to bring in our resident manager team. So let's bring Ashley and Hossein in here. So we do have a couple questions that have come in, and I think this first question would actually be great for Ashley. So Ashley, we have a question, and this is, are the Harvey Street and furnished Eagle Heights apartments available? So it sounds like Andrew says you have to apply, correct, through the leasing?
Yes, you apply through the leasing. I'm sure there is some availability. Again, I'm not sure what's available. You can contact leasing, but yes, there are. I'm biased, so I would recommend Harvey Street because like Andrew said, all of our apartments are furnished and I really think where we're located at is extremely nice. Like you said, we're right by Bagels Forever. We're right by Whole Foods. We're not too far from Starbucks. We're down the street from Target. Down the street from Pick and Save, which is a local grocery store. So if I had to pick, I would say Harvey Street. There are apartments available. You just have to apply and see what's available and set your preferences. And leasing is amazing. They will work with you so that you can get what you want or something close to what you want.
Perfect. I actually have a follow-up question that comes from us from the same individual. So it's actually a great question if you're dealing with unfurnished or furnished apartments or you just need things because, you know, you might be coming in. So the same individual asked, what are the options of buying furniture? We may not have all the furniture or household items for the apartment as we are moving from a long distance. So I know a lot of what you guys do in RMs is connecting people with resources. Yeah. So what would you recommend?
Definitely one, reach out to your resident manager. Okay. I mean, everybody can't be as fly and dope as me, but you know, reach out to the resident manager that you have. I work with a wonderful team of resident managers. Everyone is excellent. So that would be your first resource. They can connect you. We also do have a graduate housing like Facebook group. So people are constantly selling furniture or giving away furniture. So you can work that out in a Facebook group and navigate that as well. And then there are a ton of local places where you can pick up furniture as well that delivers furniture, or you can pick it up, you can see what they have. So there are a ton of options that you can do. It's just a matter of getting here and then get connected again with your resident manager. We can connect you to a ton of things.
That's so great. Thanks a lot, Ashley. So I'm going to bring Hossein in here now. So Hossein, can you tell me a little bit more about kind of the features of living in university apartments? I know there's all sorts of great things that really, you know, Andrew talked about the nuts and bolts of the building, but you kind of deal with the resident experience. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, sure. So one of the great things of being here in Eagle Heights is that we're kind of in a very special corner of Madison. We're not too far from campus. It gives us that ability to bike, walk to campus, but also since we're in an area that we have a natural preserve, there are very interesting things that you can discover. And it has a fascinating landscape that you will enjoy because there's so many exciting things you can do. So we have rolling hills where you can go hiking, and we do have trails by the lake, which are very scenic and very nice. We do have actually a Native American mound on one of the hills, which is also a very interesting feature up in the Eagle Heights Hills. And while you're going through all navigating all these different hiking paths, you might run into different kind of wildlife, and you'll see all types of wildlife. Somebody actually asked me whether there are eagles in Eagle Heights, and the answer is yes, we do. We have bald eagles, not a lot, but we do have a couple of bald eagles that settle in the forest. So a lot of the area is also covered with forests with multiple and very diverse trees and vegetation, which is interesting to discover. There's always a lot of things to do in Eagle Heights with our very special landscape, and you'll love just watching and seeing the different types of wildlife we have out there and the terrain that we have out there. So that's part of it. But also we do have some amenities, like we do have a soccer field where lots of residents come and play in their own community teams. We also have a space where you can go around the shores, you can go fishing. If you have a kayak, there is a place where you can launch your kayaks. There are lots of things to do by the lake and back in the hills and the surrounding areas in Eagle Heights. So it's a very, very fascinating landscape. I think it's one of if it's not the best, it's one of the best areas in Madison. And during the winter, one of the fun things that we do while the lake freezes is that you can walk on the ice. And for a lot of people, that's really strange. It's hard to understand, like, how can you walk on ice? And the reality is that the ice gets so thick that even a car or a small vehicle can ride on the ice. So that's really interesting to see. And there's lots of people ice fishing during the winter. So there's activities during the summer and winter that will always keep you busy. If you're here to discover the habitat around Eagle Heights. Also, we do have a lot of events at the community center. So one of the nice things of having people from all walks of life and living in a global, I would say, community is encountering people from all over the world and with different tastes and different, I would say, styles and cultures, which are very, very interesting. And we try to, during normal times, of course, we try to have multiple events where you interact with people from all over the world and get to know each other, get to know your customs and culture. And also, since we are living by Shorewood, we do interact with also the neighborhood around Eagle Heights, which is a very nice neighborhood. We have a school that is rated one of the best and top schools. It has won awards, national awards. It's called the Short Hills Elementary School, which is quite unique too, because most of the kids and families send their kids to Shorewood, which usually has a lot of exciting programming for kids. So if you're into diversity and want to interact with international people and are excited to learn new cultures and look into different types of lifestyles. Definitely, this is a place where you want to be. And if you also want to explore the outside, we have a forest, we have hills, we have a shoreline by the lake that's beautiful. We have trails and terrain that you'd love to navigate and also explore. So overall, I would say you'll never be bored here. And also, while there's so many things to going on, it is also a very quiet area of Madison. So you don't have that large traffic and sounds from the streets and ambulances and all the commuting that is about a mile away from here on University Avenue. This is a more quiet area where families enjoy lots of different activities, as I mentioned, like playing soccer, walking, hiking, fishing, sometimes kayaking. Biking is a very thing to do in the Heights. There are many roads and paths that you can take with your bike. And also, if you are into it, you can commute to the university with your bike. It's only 2 miles away, depending on where your department is. It's a very scenic path to the university. And that's one of the things I love as a grad student. I'm studying at the business school, is biking and going through that scenic path every day. You go right by the hills and then down by the shore, and you get to see what's going on by the lake, and then you bike up another hill or two and you get to your department. So it's really an exciting path, and it's not too long. It's not 10 miles. It's only 2 miles away. So it's enough for you to get that exercise, that 15 minutes of exercise in the morning or in the afternoon when you bike back. And if you can't bike, the metro system is giving this option where you can put your bike on the bus and you can ride back with the bus. So we do give free passes to students through ASM, students of all walks of life, they get to use the bus system for free. And that's one of the perks of being a student at the UW. And something that's really special here in Madison is that you can put your bike on the bus and ride back if you feel tired and you don't feel like biking back. So there are lots of things that I would love to share with you. I don't know how much time I would have to go through all the small details that we encounter here. But one of the things is that if you're in for gardening, we do have a community garden where you can rent a plot and you can grow your own organic vegetables, which I have done a couple of times. And it's really exciting to make your own produce and enjoy what you have been working on during the summer. I would say usually during the summer session.
Thanks a lot, Hossein. As you can see, he's very passionate about this community, so he's a great person to have here. So if you guys do have questions that you would love to know about what it is to live in the University Apartments community, feel free to drop them into the comment section of this video. With that being said, I actually do have a question here for Andrew that I'm going to bring back here to see if he can answer for us. So Andrew, I think this is the perfect question for you. So this question is, can more than two graduate students apply as roommates for university housing? If not, is it possible to get assigned apartments in close proximity?
Yeah, good question again, keeping me on my toes. I appreciate it. Short answer, no. So if it's a two bedroom and you are roommates, two of you can live together. Unfortunately, three bedrooms are for families. You cannot have three separate roommates living in a three bedroom. Is it possible to get assigned apartments in close proximity? Yes, anything is possible. We will try to get you close to your friends if we're able to. It really depends on what apartments are available at the time that you are applying. So yes, we will do our best. There is a section when you do apply for comments in there, but I know that you will get to meet your neighbors and you will become close with them as well. So you'll have your friends that you came with as long as the friends you're going to make here.
Great. Thanks a lot, Andrew. So I actually am going to bring Ashley back in here to talk a little bit about other features of the community. So you touched on what a resident manager is, but I know there's also, isn't there childcare that's there and there's maintenance support, right? Can you talk a little bit about what's available too for those? And if you want, you can talk more about what your role is as an RM.
Yes, I'll start with childcare. We do have an Eagles Wings Childcare Center. So it's a day offer a variety of childcare programs for children ages 6 weeks old to 8 years old available Monday through Friday, and it's available year round. They are located in the University Apartments Community Center over there in the Eagle Heights neighborhood. And what's really great and unique about their program is that they focus on anti-bias and peace education. So what a way to bring up the babies who will be our future leaders. In addition, I'll just speak a little bit more about resident manager support. So again, we're stationed all throughout the neighborhood. We're here to provide some after hours assistance. We do programming. One of my favorite programs that I did for Harvest Street residents was we had a big old socially distanced snowball fight, and we built our own snowmen and we made our own snow angels. And it was just a really great way to kind of break up all the studying that we have to do. We also, you know, serve on an on-call rotating basis so that if you need to get a quick question answer, you can call for us. If there's an issue and we can solve it, we will. If not, we also have maintenance support. So they're here to help with all of our concerns. They get things fixed and they are super amazing. What I really like is that I feel like each neighborhood is even broken down for the bigger neighborhoods like University Apartments and Eagle Heights. Like maintenance are kind of assigned to that area. So they know that area, they know that neighborhood. Like the maintenance staff I've had to work with for issues like my kitchen lights went out or something like that, or I need like a drawer fixed or something, like they're really mindful and they know about your specific neighborhood and they can come in and kind of like resolve that issue pretty quickly. And if not, you can always fill out a maintenance report and you just type in the concerns that are going on. You pick your area, you pick your neighborhood, you'll immediately get a confirmation that says, okay, we got this. We got this report, and then they'll keep it open until they work through your issue and then they'll mark it resolved. So that's been super great, is to know that there's always support here. The thing is, you just have to reach out. We'll give support, just reach out and ask for the support, and it's right here. So we are willing to meet your needs. You just got to let us know what you need. Again, it could be as simple as a question, like where can I work out at? Where can I get the best ice cream, or something that needs a little bit more technical savvy and know how we can connect you to the right person. So again, it's so important, get to know your resident manager because we are here to help.
Thanks a lot, Ashley. So I think we do have time for another question here. So what I'm gonna do is read this question and I'm gonna look at my panelists here and you raise your hand, whoever thinks that they would be the perfect person to answer this question. So this is actually about refrigerators and ovens. So are refrigerators and ovens available in Eagle Heights unfurnished apartments? Who would like to take that one? Hossein, this is all you. Go ahead.
So in Eagle Heights, we do have a refrigerator and oven installed in the unit. The oven is actually for small units that we have. It is, I think, extraordinary. It's large enough to, I would say, bake a turkey in there. So we do have a large, pretty good oven installed there with a a range that has usually 4 or 5 burners on there. The refrigerators are mid-size and usually they incorporate the necessities that you would usually fill your refrigerator with. So it's a pretty decent sized refrigerator. We are very good at taking care of them. So if any issues come up with maintenance of the ovens or refrigerators, our mechanics on call are very, very good at responding very quickly and handling different technical issues that you might encounter in a kitchen in Eagle Heights. So definitely we do have great refrigerators and ovens, and you will have extraordinary time cooking in that kitchen using those different appliances. So yeah, I hope that answers the question.
Thanks a lot, Hossein. I think that was perfect. So again, if you guys are interested in learning about what other amenities or things are included into each apartment, exploring our website at go.wisc.edu/live@UA. So you can go there, check it out, explore, take those virtual tours, you guys. It's going to help you really understand where you're coming. And more else, if you have those questions, be sure to hit us up on our contact us form. So you can do that by going to go.wisc.edu/housing-contact. And they are going to get back to you as much as possible. So I really want to thank everyone for joining us here tonight. And just a reminder, if you would like to watch a replay of this live stream, or honestly, any other live stream, want to know more about university housing, be sure that you check out our Live with Bucky Live page at go.wisc.edu/livewithbuckylive. So thanks a lot so much. I want to bring our panelists back here and just thank them all for joining us. And don't make yourself a stranger. And we look forward to welcoming you to the University Apartments community come this coming year. So thanks a lot, you guys. Take care.